Today, we're reviewing the types of dental crowns. We're going to talk about the benefits and negatives associated with different types of crowns, the cost and fees, and other factors that you need to know to be better informed and make better decisions about your health. So the four main types of crowns that we're going to be talking about today are gold, porcelain fused to metal, full zirconia or porcelain fused to zirconia, and Emax crowns. So let's start with gold. I think a lot of people believe that gold is an older material, and to be honest, it was done a lot in the past, but gold crowns are still relevant, very useful, and an awesome material to choose for your back teeth. Pure gold is actually a little bit too soft to place in your mouth. So typically you are given a gold alloy, which is gold mixed with other metals like silver, palladium, platinum, and things like that. And when they're combined together, it becomes strong and very useful in your back teeth where you have very strong forces. It works well with your tissues and it's resistant to corrosion and oxidation. So some of the benefits of gold is that it is very strong even when it's thin, which is great because if you're designing a crown, you don't have to remove too much of the tooth structure to place a gold crown on top of it. It's also really gentle to your opposing teeth, meaning that it won't wear the tooth that it's hitting on too much. And the last point, which is more of a scientific point, but it has a coefficient of thermal expansion similar to that of your tooth. Let's say if you're drinking an ice cold coffee or you're drinking a hot beverage, our teeth will shrink and expand by the smallest amount. And the rate of expansion is very similar to that of the tooth, which means that it's more likely to have strong, well-sealed margins for the lifetime of the crown. I hope that makes sense. And if not, I'll definitely put a link describing what the coefficient of thermal expansion means. Now, some of the negatives of gold is, number one, it can be very pricey. Gold right now is increasing in value and it's becoming more and more expensive to use gold. And as the price of gold increases, your gold crown will increase as well. Number two is that it conducts heat and cold rather easily. And number three has got to be the color. Not a lot of my patients want gold in their mouth. They would rather prefer an all white crown. And that's the number one reason that I've seen why my patients don't choose gold. So the second crown type that we're going to talk about is a porcelain fused to metal crown. This has been one of the most commonly used materials in the past until the advent of zirconia and Emax, which is being used more and more often in dentistry. And in this type of crown, a natural white porcelain is stacked on top of a metal and it's placed in your mouth. So basically what that means is that if you look at the underside of the crown, you're gonna see a metal base, and then on top of the crown, you're gonna see the white porcelain, which mimics the color of your natural teeth. So some of the benefits of using a porcelain fused to metal crown is that the porcelain is white, so it's way more aesthetic than if you're doing a gold crown. It actually looks like your natural tooth. It looks really nice. It may be not as aesthetic as the crowns that we're gonna talk about later in this video, but it's still very nice. It can be cemented rather easily by the dentist, which means that it's less technique sensitive than other crowns. And the last benefit is that it is strong and durable, and it's really good for the back teeth as well. Now for the negatives, the dark metal that we talked about that's on the base of the crown, sometimes you can see a metal edge if you have gum recession, and that metal will show through and people may not like to see that metal line along the gum line. Number two is, like I said before, if the porcelain fractures and the metal covers the tooth, it's still protected, but that can still show the metal, and maybe we have patients that don't want to have any metal in their body. Number three is that even though you have that white porcelain stacked on top of it, doesn't really have good translucency properties, and that's showing that natural shade of the tooth underneath the crown because it's blocked by that opaque metal. So even though the aesthetics are better than gold, they aren't the best material of choice if you're working on your front teeth. Now the third crown we're going to talk about has become more and more popular because of its strength and aesthetics. And I'm of course talking about zirconia. Zirconia is a white crystalline oxide made from the metal zirconia. It looks white all around the tooth, the inside and the outside, and it's actually really aesthetic and really strong. The benefits of zirconia is that it is incredibly strong, which means it is less likely to break than some of the other crowns. It doesn't have that dark metal base, so it's all white all around the tooth, so even if you have recession, you won't see that dark line that we talked about earlier. It can be easily cemented on by your dentist, and it can be less expensive than gold crowns because nowadays we have digital technology which allows us to mill crowns, and that cuts down on the cost a bit. Now, the main negative of zirconia is that when you have a crown that's so strong, that can actually be damaging to the tooth itself. So you have to make sure that your occlusion or your bite is adjusted perfectly so that you don't impose trauma on your tooth. Zirconia is a little bit difficult to adjust for the dentist. It's harder to cut back zirconia, but it needs to be adjusted perfectly so that your bite works. Typically, if the bite is off, you will definitely feel a painful sensation along the root of your tooth, or I guess on your tooth itself. So that is definitely a negative that we have to consider. And as a side note, zirconia does have translucency properties, and it can look really, really pretty. But if you want to get even better aesthetics, sometimes you can layer porcelain on top of zirconia, beautiful porcelain on top of zirconia, and you can get a really lifelike crown that you will love. The final crown that we're going to talk about is Emax. Emax crowns are the most aesthetic crowns on the market, and they can really do a good job at making lifelike restorations that appear to look just like your natural teeth. Emax is an all-ceramic system that uses lithium disilicate glass to make a beautiful crown. The benefits of Emax is that it can be bonded to your teeth, which allows the dentist to do more conservative preparations, or it allows the dentist to work with unfavorable teeth that maybe don't have the best prognosis. And bonding onto the tooth can make it a little bit stronger. All ceramic, so there's no metal to be seen. It has great translucency and light reflective properties. And finally, it's just the best match, and I typically use it for the anterior teeth because it looks so good. Now, for the negatives, it has a really high price point. It's not really good for dark teeth or people that have tetracycline staining or a really dark color to their teeth. Because of the translucency properties of the Emax, sometimes the underlying tooth will show through if you don't have the appropriate thickness of the Emax. And if you're doing an Emax full coverage crown, then the dentist does have to do an aggressive preparation design in order to have a minimum thickness of crown material to make it strong and long lasting. Zirconia and gold don't need this aggressive preparation to allow them to make crowns that work. So that is something that you need to consider. So what do I currently do? Well, you know, every dentist is different. Don't take my word above everyone else, but this is what I do. This is what works well in my hands. I think porcelain fused to metal crowns are still great and can be used for the back teeth. I typically like to do full zirconia crowns when I'm working on the posterior teeth. They do have really aesthetic zirconia crowns on the market that have really good translucency properties, so zirconia is a great material for that. Gold crowns are really good for people that have heavy bruxing or heavy bite forces, or if the tooth is so small to begin with and you can't achieve proper isolation, gold can be long-lasting and very strong and really good for those type of patients. Now, for the front teeth, I prefer Emax or lithium disilicate. Typically, Emax gives me the best results, the most lifelike results, and I haven't been disappointed much when I work with Emax crowns. So I like to do Emax on the front teeth. I like to do gold for the second molars, the teeth all the way in the back. I like to do zirconia for the molars and sometimes the premolars. And PFMs, I think, can still be used, but typically I prefer those on the back. If you are a dentist doing PFM, remember it does have that metal margin. So if you're working on the back teeth and aesthetics is of concern to the patient, then you want to drop the margins slightly subgingival so that you can mask that metal margin and that your patient will be really happy. So what about the dental crown cost and the price associated with these different crowns that we're talking about? Remember that the cost of your crown varies depending on the geographical location, basically where you live in the the world. So you're gonna have a high or low cost depending on whether you live in Beverly Hills or you live in a suburban town somewhere else in the United States. Now, with that understanding, there is still a difference in cost for all the materials that I just mentioned. Well, I hope that helps. If you want to share this video, that'd be much appreciated. Please leave a like on the video and comment down below if you have questions that you want answered, and I'll definitely see you for the next one.